Hello everybody, ladies, gentlemen, people that can't choose, people that don't want to choose, and people that feel like a clown today. I am John, and my name is Aftermath, and I'm playing Yooka Laylee, not alone.
Hello, my name is Raiden. I have appeared in a few of the videos on the channel, in case you have seen them. I play Arsi.
Yeah, he plays Arsi sometimes. Just that Bulgarian
Oh, what? Triggered.
Triggered. That Bulgarian asshole that I have taking along for things that I can't be asked doing alone. Yooka Laylee is going to be a bit different as a deviation. We're going to do very long parts. Think about it like an hour. And they're going to be kind of like a podcast. Maybe different. And essentially the idea is that we drown it out. You just listen to it as long as you want to listen to it. And that's it. We're probably not going to talk about the game a whole lot, actually, if it didn't crash. Did it crash? Shit, please don't crash. Oh, it didn't crash, cool.
Nice.
So, Ryan, do you know anything about Yooka Laylee?
Besides the whole Jontron thing?
Oh, please, and that... no. No politics. Okay, look. This Let's Play is a politics-free Let's Play, because there's different reasons why I play Yooka Laylee, that has nothing to do with Jontron or the lack thereof. So, do you know anything about Yooka Laylee?
Other than that, it's like made by the same people that worked on Banjoo Kazooie back in the day, and it's basically a ripoff. Not really.
What do you mean a ripoff? I mean, it's essentially a remake more than anything, isn't it?
It's kind of a ripoff, honestly. I mean, it's just like it's basically like the exact same fucking thing.
Okay. Well, I mean, you are not wrong. By the way, if the game is lagging for you right now, that's because I have to change my camera because I've just realized it's in the middle of the text. All right, here we go. Stop lagging. But the thing is, if the same developer make the same game again and call it differently because licensing, is it then really a ripoff or is it a spiritual successor? If anything, I think this is a spiritual successor. It's the entire same game. I mean, you can't listen to it because of Skype, but you even have the voices, you know? I mean, okay.
Look, in my mind, if Kojima went ahead and made, like, another stealth game, that would still be a Metal Gear ripoff, you know? That's why he kind of made his own thing.
For you, ripoff is just, it means the same guy's doing the same shit under a different name. It's the same thing, it's a ripoff, yeah, alright.
I mean, yeah, basically. Like, well, why not do something different?
Isn't this rather plagiarism? Oh, because people wanted this. People have been asking for Banjo-Kazooie 3 for 20 years now. And then they announced Kickstarter, and people voted with their wallet, and they voted in favor of. So, I don't see the problem.
Yeah, but from what I've seen, it's like, it basically is Banjo-Kazooie.
Is that a bad thing? Everybody wanted Banjo-Kazooie.
Yeah, but there's nothing added to the formula. There's nothing changed. It's literally the exact same game, just for next gen.
But do you remember Mighty No. 9 that added charge dashing into enemies to kill them faster? You know, the bad idea.
I don't see it as an inherently bad idea.
It was badly executed.
Exactly. That's the thing, though. It's badly executed. There's no such thing as a bad idea. It's just how it's implemented, you know?
Really? There's no such thing as a bad idea. How about asset flips?
That's more of a... I mean, look at all of the RPG Maker games.
That's asset flips?
Yeah, exactly. Those are basically asset
flips. They are literally asset flips. Well, I mean, exactly. Okay, asset flipping is a little bit different in the way that asset flips mean that you are making, like, stealing the assets and don't change them. RPG Maker games change it because of a different story, a different map layout, I guess. Can't really flip an entire RPG Maker game, you know what I mean? And resell it. I mean, you can.
You basically can.
No, people are just gonna notice, and the creators of RPG Maker, you know, the guys that actually made full games for you to watch, they will sue the fuck out of you. but I mean, look, if you don't have Banjo-Kazooie, we have Yooka Laylee. It's a bit different.
I don't know. Look, if I was placed in charge of making Yooka Laylee, of designing it, I would take the best stuff that worked in Banjo-Kazooie and then kind of remix it and make something different with it.
Yeah, like, you mean like nuts and bolts?
No, because nuts and bolts kind of had some really bad ideas that didn't work in it.
There were no bad ideas.
No, I mean, they were implemented badly in that particular game.
Aftermath triggers a Bulgarian part 1.
I am already regretting this.
You're going to regret this 20 hours down the line, dude. 20 hours down the line, you'll regret this.
No, look, There are no such things as bad ideas, but there are bad ideas for particular games, and there are bad ways in which these ideas can be implemented. You know?
How about we just call it bad execution?
Basically, yeah,
okay,
pretty much.
Good.
But my point is that you don't need to do the exact same game, because that's basically it. Yooka Laylee is basically Banjo Kazooie, right?
Well, Banjo Kazooie was essentially Banjo Tooie.
Yeah. Wait, wasn't Banjo-Tooie the second game?
Yeah, it was the second game. It's essentially the same game, is what I mean. Actually, as a matter of fact, Banjo-Tooie was kinda worse than Banjo-Kazooie. It was slower.
You can't really capture the magic of the original.
No, it's just slower. They tried new things, they didn't work out.
Well, I mean, sometimes it works out, sometimes it isn't. I mean, look at Assassin's Creed, right? Because you have Assassin's Creed 1, which had the core concepts of infiltration and assassination in a historical setting, right?
Yeah.
So Assassin's Creed 2 took those core concepts and applied them to a different game while adding more stuff to it. There were no longer... Because in Assassin's Creed 1, if you remember, the main method of approaching your target, you basically had to do like these mini-games. You had to race and collect flags, or you had to trail your target or some shit. And nobody liked to play that. All we wanted was to get the target.
So yeah, you're right. Assassin's Creed 1, in a way, was the best Assassin's Creed and the most boring one at the same time.
Yeah, I mean... In a way, I'm not going to argue with that, but look, the thing is, Assassin's Creed 2 took the stuff from the first game that worked and removed the stuff that didn't and replaced it with other stuff. Now, look, some of the stuff in Assassin's Creed 2 didn't work, right? Like the gondola stuff in Venice, like that shit, nobody liked that.
No,
I don't think anybody.
It's just boring.
Exactly, yeah. Like, there was shit in Assassin's Creed, the feather collections. To get the hammer or something. Nobody liked that. But there were also a lot of stuff in Assassin's Creed 2 that worked. And if Assassin's Creed 2 was literally just Assassin's Creed 1 with better graphics, I don't think it would have been as good of a game as it ended up being.
That is very true, because Assassin's Creed 2 was maybe the best Assassin's Creed, in my opinion at least.
Yeah, basically.
I mean, I personally like Black Flag more, but Black Flag is not really Assassin's Creed. It's just
Black Flag is...
Game.
I mean, the main character isn't even an assassin in that game. He just has the assassin outfit. Yeah, he was never officially inducted into the assassin order.
That's true.
Yeah, like they invite
him.
Wait
a minute, is this canon saying that this canon with the name of Blaster saying that his throat hurts and he lost his voice? Really?
Wow, that's some.
That's questionable writing. I mean, look, this game is aimed at kids. All right, let's not forget that.
That's giving me some, what was the game, Conker vibes right there.
Yeah, it is. Well, Conker's Bad Fur Day is essentially Banjo-Kazooie and for 18+. So.
Yeah, basically.
Yeah, but then just a parrot flew into this. So he wants to be whipped into shape. Is that what I got? Like, doesn't seem like I can help it right now. Trouser, exactly. I don't have to move yet. Trouser is the snake, by the way. That is a pants of trousers.
Oh boy.
Trousers. You missed him. What? He actually already was.
No, I saw him. I saw him.
Yeah, that was trousers.
Yeah, why would a snake even need to wear trousers anyway? He's a snake.
Dude, it's trousers. It's Indiana trousers. Jesus fucking Christ, dude. Stop. My immersion.
My immersion.
My immersion. My face is tired. My face is tired of your bullshit. But yeah. Okay, I can't run up there. That's cool. Totally. Absolutely. Yep, I totally forgot that Banjo-Kazooie, you need to learn literally everything. I know trousers. Hi, trousers. It really looks a little bit weird, to be honest. But
most
no, this is... But no, aside from shitting on JonTron and more importantly shitting on this game, the reason I want to play this game and the reason why I'm completely, absolutely losing all my... I'm going to lose my integrity here because I'm going to make a bold statement. I'm only playing this game for nostalgia and I don't care about its flaws. If this game is literally Banjo-Kazooie, then that's perfect because I want literally Banjo-Kazooie.
Oh well.
I don't want anything else.
But look, if you literally want Banjo-Kazooie, why don't you just play Banjo-Kazooie?
I mean, that's a good idea, but I finished it like 7 times. So, I don't know. There's not much more I could do except for start speedrunning it. Besides, I don't have the cartridge anymore. I did find my N64, but I don't have the cartridge anymore. It's so expensive, dude. Yeah, I could emulate it, but Jesus, you know, nothing. Like, this is a PlayStation 2 controller. Nothing goes over having an N64 controller in your hand while playing banjoo. You know what I mean?
I guess. I don't know, I never quite got used to the N64 controller. Maybe
no,
because
I still don't, it's kind of shit.
Yeah, it is pretty shit.
But I could still beat Star Fox on Expert with all medals in a single run without needing to charge a trick for bombs without dying. So I'm still pretty good at that game.
That's kind of impressive.
10 years later. Expert is really fucking annoying because the moment you start Expert, the moment something crashes at you, you just lose your wings and your strong laser. So I prefer playing not casual because it's just easier. But what I was saying is I want Yooka Laylee to be Project Kazooie because that's what I wanted from this game.
I mean, I guess it makes sense, but like, look, I think that we've got very different tastes when it comes to games. With me, I'm always up for new experiences, pushing the envelope, moving the industry forward. Or for you, you're just like, oh, you know, it's fine to stay where we are. I just like the simple stuff, you know, that's kind of the same.
That's what I said. I mean, all right, I mean, you can get the feeling, especially because I like Doom and you don't. But
yeah, that's
what I think about is, think about it, yeah? When is the last time? Okay, I'm not counting Ratchet and Clank because my face went no PS4. When is the last time we had a fucking mascot platformer that wasn't shite?
Well, from what I'm seeing, Yooka Laylee isn't that good either. So, you know, basically, I mean, a long time ago.
Essentially, here's the thing, right?
Oh, in fairness, the new Ratchet and Clank game was actually pretty good.
That's what I said. That's why I'm counting it. How do I duck? Ah, here we go. Cool. No, here's the thing. Yooka Laylee, I read the critiques, right? The reason it gets downvoted a lot is literally because it is the same and it still has the old bad controls. And look, I said before that I don't mind that. So if it's literally the same with the same shitty controls, I don't actually fucking mind this for once. Like, for once, I don't mind that. I know it's not very integral to say that, nor neither is it making me a good critic. But honestly, I really don't kind of care. I think it's a good mascot platformer just because it is the same, like the old mascot platformers.
Yeah, but look, the thing is, what I'm actually noticing is that Doom was also the exact same game as it was like 20 years ago.
No.
Yeah, it was just updated to you.
No, actually, Doom 1 and Doom 2 much more technical and much slower than the new Doom. New Doom is really just face mech shooty. Old Doom's lots of tactic, lots of kiting, lots of slow gameplay. Not a lot of go in and kill anything. No, really, the game is faster because of the execution mechanics. That makes the game much, much faster. Like, if you play the old Doom, if you go back to it now, you'll understand what I mean.
Maybe, but no. The same feelings that I got from playing the new one is the same ones that I got from playing the old ones.
I'm not sure if
ones.
I should be supposed to be up here.
No, look, okay, so basically the point that I was trying to come across is that, do you think that Yooka Laylee was going to get better reviews if it was just called Banjo-Kazooie?
No, because it has still gotten those shitty controls. The critic raised to this game is fair, from what I can tell. If it ends up true what they say, then it's fair criticism. That's what I mean, you know what I mean? Most of the critics don't say, it's just like Banjo-Kazooie, just shit. They say the controls are still those of an N64. Or to put it simply, it encapsulates N64 games, and that includes all its flaws. That's what the most critics say, you know? The first statement is not a bad thing. The second one is. You know what I mean?
Yeah, kind of.
Yeah, and if they would have not fixed those flaws, maybe it would have gotten like 4 points more. Because IGN likes to give 7 out of 10, you know? Maybe it got 4 or 5 points more. It wouldn't have been a 90. It wouldn't have been an 80. You know what I mean?
Yeah, kind of. Yeah.
Yeah. No, I think it's fair, actually. Like, from what I can tell, the controls really are like back in the old days. That's not a good thing, because those controls suck ass. I personally, as I said, don't mind that. I know it's bad. I just don't mind it very much. But yeah, it's still there. It's still ass. Oh, I see. I can't go in here. Because something is sleeping, and I was like, maybe I could talk to it. Nah.
Can you actually control the camera with the right analog, or can you? Or is it fixed?
I can. I just didn't configure it because a PlayStation 2 controller doesn't work without X-Padder. And I like to put my camera control buttons on R1 and L1 instead. It's just what? I'm used to that.
Oh, okay then. Seems awfully inconvenient, but whatever floats your boat.
No, I'm just used to that a lot. Like, I get a similar feeling from when I use my mouse to play games, you know? Where I just snap 90 degrees in one direction with the mouse. That's just how I like to play games.
It reminds me of how Persona 3 Portable kind of did it. That exploration in Tartarus kind of worked the exact same way there.
Yeah, and I don't like that. I actually do. Alright,
I don't know. It's super sluggish to me. When I replayed Persona 3 Portable on the Vita, I just mapped them to the right analog stick, and it felt so much better.
Huh. But now we have this one problem where I don't fucking know what to do. That was fast. Maybe I just need to investigate the part. Oh yeah, right. I'm stupid. But whatever, this is a drownout, so we are probably going to play, not make progress, and ignore the complete game most of the time, so who cares? Anyway, yes. Cool. Now we talk. That's why I want to play Yooka Laylee anyway, and I understand your criticism, I just choose to ignore it this time.
Okay then, fair enough.
I mean, it's. Look. You probably have a game or two that you enjoy that are utter shit, and where you just.
Oh, yeah, obviously, yeah. Of course. Yeah,
this is going to be one of those games for me here, I can tell. Like, 10 seconds in, and I can tell. Okay. Maybe like this. Something tells me that I need to. Oh, I see. Alright, that. Yeah, I see. Maybe? Do I see something? No. Ah, fucking damn it. Zero possibility space. Okay, so. Oh, actually, he told me I can't get in, and he closed the door, and now I can get in.
I think the game glitched on you.
Maybe. I don't know. I don't really care. If that glitches, then I can understand the score even a bit more. Oh, wow. Hi. Ah, okay. Hi, Trousers. You just teleported, didn't you? Cool. So what have you been up to, Mr. Raiden? Let me guess. Play Persona 5.
Oh, obviously.
And before that, you finished Nier Automata? Or have you taken a break from that?
No, like I basically completed Nier Automata and then jumped immediately into Persona 5.
And it's kind of sad that Persona 5 came around, because to put it in your own words, Nier Automata is one of those games you would have laid back and put 500 hours into.
Basically, it's just such... there was so much shit that I wanted to do, especially because Nier Automata has such a rich world that is just below the surface. I mean, there's an entire side quest with Emil from the first Nier game, where you have to go around the world and collect these flowers in order to uncover his backstory. And you need to collect weapons, which give you more of the lore of the game. And there's all the endings that you need to get, and all the side quests and all that kind of stuff. And I really wanted to do everything, but I basically had to stop after I got the true ending because, you know, Persona.
Yeah, but you know what I think is interesting? I remember you being a very vocal critic of Dark Souls. Nier Automata does it almost the same, except that Nier Automata has two characters that keep talking while nothing happens. If they would cut 9S or 2B out of the game and just have one character go through it, it would be essentially like Dark Souls.
Yeah, basically. But
you are a very vocal critic of Dark Souls and not of Nier Automata. It's probably because Nier Automata is not a sluggish game because it's made by Platinum.
Well, I mean, you kind of answered your own question there. You're like, Dark Souls did this thing and Nier Automata did it differently. And yet you hate Dark Souls but don't hate Nier Automata. Why is that?
I think I was actually under the assumption that the general principle of world exploration presented in Dark Souls is something that you didn't like. Obviously, that was wrong. You really like the way it presents the world. What you didn't like was everything else.
No,
like
look.
How sluggish the game was.
Look, the thing is, you can actually complete the Nier Automata, like all of it, without really, uncovering most of what the world has to offer. You know, you can complete it with the real ending, without really going underground, without really uncovering most of the side quests, without doing any sort of real exploration. But the thing is, with Dark Souls, you can't really do that. I mean, there's nothing, nobody really telling you where to go. There's no minimap, there's no quests that you need to undertake. It's just, you kind of wander around this open world until something happens. Yeah. That's kind of my real problem, the lack of clear objective, the lack of clearly defined objective.
But wait, for every reviewer who had just realized that I had some frame drops, and by that I mean complete stops, I wanted to reconfigure the X pedal a little bit because my R1 key is bound to two different things, and that's a little bit annoying. But anyway, yes, I understand that because, to be honest, yeah, Dark Souls is pretty bleak and empty, and has nothing to tell you to do anything, which is, I mean, I guess it's part of the charm of Dark Souls. Not everybody has to like it, though.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, look, if you enjoy it, that's great, but...
Nobody has to enjoy it. And I understand why Nier Automata is better. I mean, look at the game. It's a fluid, fucking action-paced fighter with RPG elements.
And there are major RPG elements, too. It's like elements. Leveling, skill trees. Yep.
Yeah, it's essentially a really good platinum game.
Basically. It's one of the best platinum games ever made, if I may say so myself.
It's probably not because of the fighting, though. It's probably because of the story. Yooka Laylee is a god.
Yeah, basically.
Oh my god, remember, have you ever played the Dragon Guard 3?
No, but I really want to play it.
Oh,
seems
dude,
pretty awesome.
The last boss is amazing as balls. Except there's one problem with it, so just so you know, yeah? In the last boss, I'm not going to spoil you what it does, right? But just be aware, when you're at the last boss, you'll understand what I mean, right? You're going to tap buttons during that boss. And when the screen fades to black at the very end of the boss, you still will have to tap the button once more, otherwise it's game over. Yes, after the boss fight ends, it will fuck you over if you don't know it. So be aware that if the boss fight ends and it fades to black, keep that button pressed, or at least press it. You might have to... A little bit of you might have to do a little bit of guesswork, but better than going game over after a 7-minute fight.
Yeah, I'm gonna keep that in mind, but I'm honestly not sure when I'm gonna get to that game, because I've got a whole ton of games to go get through.
Yeah, I know about that. You have essentially no time, and when you have it, you either spend it with me or with Persona 5 right now.
Basically. And after I'm done with Persona, I've still got I also got The Last Guardian. I also got like basically every single Kingdom Hearts game ever made. I really want to get through that. There's Final Fantasy 15. I haven't really touched that one, and I really want to.
Huh.
Just so many games. And then there's all the Vita games that I have been ignoring.
Yeah, well, the Vita games, you know, the Vita games. Vita has games? I can't think of any.
Don't make me strangle you in your sleep.
Implying you come to Germany to strangle me.
Yeah, if you talk shit about the Vita, I will physically come to Germany just to strangle you.
Yeah, whatever. I'm just going to do whatever.
Guys, if one morning the channel stops uploading, this is why. Keep that in mind.
Yes, definitely. Oh, I didn't actually want to talk with you because I didn't. Okay, so this works perfectly. Hey, cool. This is essentially like back in the days, but... riding on the back of Kazoie, just a little bit more shit.
Yeah, basically.
No, it's actually the same. I was more or less joking. it plays the exact same. Anyway, yes. The antagonist of the series is apparently called Capital B. It is a B businessman. Capital B. Man, what are we playing? Yooka B movie? Can I smash the shit open?
Nope, I'm thinking you're gonna need a key, which is hidden in some kind of dungeon or whatever. Because they always are.
I think maybe it has something to do with this, and I can't solve this right now. Oh, this is an Easter egg, which I don't get. Well, let's roll around and find out.
No, I think that's just the clue, it's not the actual puzzle. It's just some kind of clue that you need to use.
Who knows? I don't know. You made it to the first Grand Tome. What the fuck is a Grand Tome? Magic Gateways to New Woods. Ah, alright. I see. This is essentially the hub world I'm in right now, obviously.
Wait, so why are you collecting these pages again?
So I can open the door and collect more pages. And those pages are the golden pages of the bat. I don't know if it's Yooka Laylee. It's probably Laylee. But yeah, Laylee has a big book. You know, a checkbook, a financial book, a money book. All of them are golden pages. And somebody just stole them.
Oh boy.
So it's a greedy Jewish bat. And we are basically collecting his money again. I mean, he takes the place of Kazooie, which obviously was a very fourth wall breaking shithead bird. Like, holy shit, that shithead bird. I mean, Jesus. It was pretty bad. And so, yeah, obviously that makes a lot of sense. Alright, so tell me more about Persona 5.
Well, what do you want to know about it?
So, let's start. Pitch me the idea. What's Persona 5 all about? Like, I played Persona 3 and 4, so what's Persona 5 all about? I actually know, I'm just gonna, you know, for the viewers.
Yeah, makes sense. But yeah, Persona 5 is all about, you know, thieves. That's the main theme of the game. Stealing people's hearts.
I just died. Anyway.
What did you even do there?
I have no idea. My analog sticks are being ass.
My God.
This roll function is... Oh, I get why. Or do I get why?
Because
I totally get why.
But do you get why?
Yeah, I do get why.
Do you truly get why?
Yes, I totally fucking get why now. It's
but why if you don't get why? Why if you only think you get why?
Look, I know what I'm about to say. I know how the double configuration happens, and I'm going to fix it right now. I'm sorry, guys. I just have to. Because this is annoying as absolute ballsack. I'm going to remap everything to keys, where I'm pretty sure that nothing happens. And then I have only one controller, and then that works.
As it's supposed you should just buy an Xbox 360 controller.
Oh,
over.
You mean this one right here, and that one with this thing? Yeah, you can't see it, but the people can. Not working.
Well, why aren't you using it?
It's not working. I don't know why.
Oh my God! Well, buy another one.
I did. It's not working.
Well, maybe it's firmware issue or something.
Well, maybe you don't have friends.
Mom said not to tell me that.
Mom told you not to tell me that. A good one. Anyway, yes. Where was I? No, it's fixed now. So it's fine.
It's fixed now, unlike your love life.
Oh. Well, compared to you, at least I have a love life.
Oh!
I'm kidding, I don't. Please date me. Like, as long as you are female, if you are a trap, piss off, but if you're female, I definitely date you.
What, you got something against traps?
Yeah, that's pretty gay. That's how I have against traps. So yeah, it's about stealing hearts, but no, seriously, now, what is Persona 5 all about? Tell me. It really is about stealing hearts, in which case...
It literally is about stealing hearts. I mean, okay, so basically this is how it works, right? So, basically, whenever there's someone who is super, super fucking evil, I mean, like, talking Hitler-level evil here, these people have these things called palaces. So palaces are, in another world, like, think like the Dark Hour from Persona 3 or the TV world from Persona 4. And these palaces are basically twisted representations of their inner worlds. But what you have to do is infiltrate these palaces, sneak through them, get to their very center, and then steal a treasure from them. And that treasure represents their hearts. And if you steal that heart, you also steal away their desires. So basically you cause them to have a change of heart and to become good people.
That sounds absolutely disgusting. Look, I don't want to hate. What the fuck? This is a cloud? Oh, is this a race cloud? This is Laylee. Okay, Yooka is the lizard. Nimble. She is nimble, alright. A race. Alright, let's do a race then. Cool. So you make assholes into not assholes.
Basically, yeah.
Doesn't that make you assholes? Don't people have a free way of, you know, being able and allowed to choose what the fuck they want?
No, because the assholes that we're going after are fucking rapists and shit.
Oh, okay. So that's really assholes.
Exactly, yeah. That's what I'm telling you. Like, in order to have a castle, you need to be Hitler level.
Well, I don't think that Hitler was as bad as rapists. I think Hitler was quite a bit worse than rapists. I mean, he raped an entire race of people to speak.
No, he raped several races of people, if you were to be honest.
But not only several it's not only several, like, races of people, just several million people.
In general, yeah. He raped all of Europe.
Yeah, well, with tanks. He's pretty good at that, actually. I don't want to like sound like a Hitler fan or anything, but I'm closely a Hitler fan. In my closet. I'm coming out of it. I'm coming out of the closet, guys. You better respect my decision to be a trans Hitler. That means I'm feeling German most of the time, but sometimes I wake up and I'm just feeling like Hitler.
You're Hitler fluid.
Hitler fluid, alright. It's fine, piss off.
What are we doing? This video is gonna get so many dislikes.
I don't care, I have Nintendo fan haters anyway. If people don't get a few Hitler jokes from a German, you have to check your privilege, to be fair. Like, come on, if a German makes Hitler joke, check your privilege if you don't like it. Like, I'm sorry, what else am I supposed to say? I'm right. Start the fucking race when you say go.
Go!
No, no, go. I mean, she said go like 5 minutes ago, still no go.
Seriously?
Yeah, here we go. Okay, I knew what I did wrong last time, so I'm gonna fix it this time. It's pretty, actually quite simple, I just have to eat some butterflies. If you don't eat them, she's gonna fuck you, okay, son? Like, you will not like what she will do to you. Hey, she gives me speed, nice! Continue!
Oh my god! Can you just like spend the entire race just standing in front of her?
No, that's not how it works, sadly. I tried that last time, but it didn't work.
Dang it. They think about everything.
They think about everything except fixing bugs and making good games. But let's just not think about how to fix our game. Let's just think about how to apply our latest version of the Nouveau on it. Because those people are the best people. Nah, jokey, this game is without DM since it's on GOG. And GOG means no DM, but I bought it. I bought it! Why are you looking at me like this, Adrian? I bought it!
Fucking parrot.
No. Fucking Adrian. Always speaking a parrot every game. Did he just shower pages on me? Wow, that's kinky. Okay. Well, essentially, I don't have any idea. Whoa, what the fuck? Ouch! You piece of shit! Dude! Okay, I probably can't kill him.
Is that some kind of boss fight or something? What is it?
I don't know what this is. It's just annoying, quite frankly. I don't know if... I don't think I should be here right now. Maybe later. It's probably defending something. Where's the banjoo in the game? Oh, look, Trouser, hi.
Well, how can he count mill move so quickly? He's wearing trousers.
Maybe it's because he's wearing trousers.
Dear Lord. The revelations.
I mean, look, he has a telephone in his trousers where his dick should be, but there isn't a dick because it's a snake. Maybe there's a portal generator somewhere in there too. You know, one of those big ones of Star Trek Galactica?
Yep.
Yeah, Stargate Galactica. Those fucking things.
Wait, Star Trek Galactica?
No, Stargate Galactica.
Oh, Stargate.
I just mixed three things. Star Trek Galactica, Battlestar Galactica, Star Trek. No, Stargate Atlantis, sorry.
Yeah, that's... Because the thing is, I'm not super into sci-fi. When you were like Star Trek Atlantis Galactica, and I was just like, wait a minute, that really doesn't sound right.
But yeah, I think I need to body slam. I think I need that the most, right?
I guess.
Great video, one left. Oh no, fucking really, like, really. Okay, cool. What a Jew. Reminds me of that guy at Spyro 2 that takes money for you to repair bridges that you need to do to save the fucking world he's living in. But then he has to give you all the money back at the end of it. Money Banks was an idiot. Asshole.
Like the, literally every single RPG game merchant ever.
No, like look, that Spyro 2 situation was a bit bad. Like, there was literally a bridge between you and the last boss. He was like, give me 1,000. And you're like, I don't have 1,000. Yeah, then fuck it, the last boss can wait now, can't he?
No, I mean, he's like, okay, so, like, in literally every single RPG ever, when you're about to go fight the last boss in the final fucking dungeon, which is in some kind of sky dimension, oh, you're about to save the world from imminent destruction? Okay, well, how about you check out my wares? Oh, okay, can't you just give me some shit for free because I'm about to save the world? Oh, well, you know, capitalism is capitalism.
It is. It really is. Okay, now I have a body slam. Can I wake up the peoples with this? No. Okay, that's wrong, obviously. I can't beat them, but maybe I can just do this. Aha, here we go. Hello up there. Okay, what is this? Okay, so he wants me to destroy the block windows. Okay, I can deal with that. So let's talk more about Persona.
Alrighty. So, where was I? Before we started talking about Star Trek Galactica.
Yeah, you were about Hart's Palace.
Yeah. But yeah, basically, you know, the guys that you have to steal these hearts from, I mean, there's two that's the kind of thing that I really like about Persona, like Persona 5 in particular, because Persona 3 had Tartarus, which was like, you know, the huge tower of infinite floors that you needed to get through, and while Persona 4 had these smaller dungeons that you needed to go through, which were all individual and tailored to the story, right? Well, Persona 5 has both of those things.
Huh.
Yeah, like, there's bigger dungeons, like the palaces, which are actually not randomly generated, by the way. They're all handcrafted. So, each one of them is different. Each one of them has like, these specific rooms and challenges and puzzles and shit that you need to do. And aside from that, you also have this place called Mementos, which is basically, imagine Tartarus, but upside down. Instead of going up, you go down. And
so you descend hell.
Yeah, basically. But it's think of it as you know how like every single person with dark desires has a palace. Mementos is the palace that all of humanity has. You know, like all of humanity's dark desires manifesting in a single spot.
Oh wow! So you can grind, go stealth, or work on social links same time.
No. No, like, the social links are, like, an entirely different thing. Oh, and by the way, they're no longer called social links.
Oh, what are they called then?
Confidants.
Confidants? Oh, fuck.
Yeah, I don't fucking know, man.
At least you're definitely literally not killing Hitler, back like in Persona 2, but you literally
killed Hitler. Yeah. Oh, if only Hitler had a palace, maybe we could have changed his heart.
No, probably couldn't, because he believed he'd be right.
Hey, maybe that's what happened.
Here's the thing. I have a question, alright? This is important. When I talk about Persona, in a way, right?
Yeah.
I'm thinking a lot about having to manage time. Because you need to work on your social links for the fucking experience points, otherwise Persona suck ass.
Yeah,
But you also kinda need to grind, otherwise your character suck even bigger ass.
Like yeah, but it's not fighting the same way.
Okay, but what is the urgency? Like you said, we're stopping rapists. So what's the urgency? Is he just gonna rape somebody else?
No, basically it's different every time. For example, the first guy is he's like a teacher at your school, and he's like basically the next time there's a student council a teacher's council meeting, I'm going to propose that you guys get expelled from school.
Oh, and so we're literally do this out of self-interest. Not even because you want to help him.
Well, no, that's the first guy. That's why you have to do this, because you start investigating him, and you realize that he's actually up to some really shitty stuff, and then he catches on to you that you're trying to investigate him, and he's like, yo, lol, I'm gonna get you expelled at the next meeting. And so you basically have to change his heart, you have to steal his heart before that meeting happens, which is like in 12 days or something like that.
Okay, so in other words, what kind of? Okay, never mind. Don't spoil. Okay. So he's just up to no good, and you find that out after, and then he wants to expel you. So it's not like he wants to expel you because you're just an ass, and then you'll become even more of an ass and basically change his personality.
Yeah, I mean, no, you don't really change his personality exactly. I mean, you kind of do, but what you do is you take away his dark desires. So if he wants to rape people, after you steal his heart, he no longer wants to rape people, and he actually feels so regret for having raped people.
Trigger warning, by the way, we would say rape a few times in this video.
Oh, no, I'm sorry. It looks like you're not going to get any monetizations for this one.
Yeah, man. Must suck to be a YouTuber in 2017, am I right?
Yep.
It's not like I earn a lot of money or anything, but hey, who cares? Must suck to be a YouTuber 2017. Yeah, pretty much. You can just say something like along the lines of Trump, and everybody assumes you like Trump, and then everybody hates you. But so if you just say Trump, then you're basically downvoted for life, dude.
Yeah, so well, I guess what you need to do is Trump the other review YouTubers, huh? Oh,
okay, huh? I just found something. Yeah, that's bad. That was a bad pun. You're bad for it, please. He's just all the way up here and he has literally nothing.
Best game, 10 of 10.
Whoop-a-la, that's the way I wanted to go. What the fuck, is that a pick? Is that a pick in a knight armor? That's a pick in a knight armor. Om nom nom, alright. Young warrior, he calls himself warrior.
Oh yeah, and of course he eats a lot. Because what pig doesn't, right?
Even before he is called Sir Eats a Lot. No, Sir Scoffs a Lot.
Porkins.
He's called like Scoffs a Lot. Scoffs a Lot, of course. A proud out of ham a lot. Scoffs a lot from ham a lot. Alright, okay. But anyway, yes. So essentially, you're just being a dick, you're being like, okay, because you're like, okay, you realize those people are actually more dicks than you, so that justifies your actions.
I mean, yeah, basically. I mean, you have to be, like I said, you have to be a colossal dick in order to have a palace, so, you know.
No, I mean, like, you want to be like, you abuse your powers for yourself just a little bit, and then you realize, oh, those people are bigger dicks. No, mate, it's justified.
No, like I said, you start investigating him, and then you actually start making it a little bit selfish, because he catches you investigating him, and that's when he threatens you.
And then you realize he's even fucked up, more fucked up than you previously assumed.
I mean, basically. Like, I don't want to spoil too much, but that's basically, and that's just the first target. Later on, as you find out more and more targets, you basically start doing it out of the goodness of your own heart.
Oh yeah, just of course.
Save the world and shit.
Yeah, let me guess, at the end of the day, you have a palace too because you don't want to be lonely like a Persona 2, 3, and 4.
I mean, I have no idea, honestly.
You haven't finished the game yet, right?
Nope. I'm
okay,
still
spoiler
at
spoiler warning, you die. No, I'm joking, I don't know if you die.
Oh, no!
I don't actually really know that, so if you die, it wasn't a spoiler.
I mean, honestly, at this point, if I die, that would actually be a pretty good ending.
Oh, really?
Seriously, the Persona 4 ending where you don't die is just such a fucking rip happy ending bullshit.
Dude, happy ending bullshit is sometimes really good, especially in dark stories. Just saying.
Yeah, but Persona 4 wasn't a dark story.
Oh no, it's just about stopping rapists from raping more people.
What? Persona 4 was about rapists?
Oh. No, but Persona 3 was a happy dark story, I mean.
Oh, well, yeah. Persona 3 was like super dark. Persona 3 was all about death.
Of course you die at the end.
Yeah, like
Persona... Oh, spoiler warning, you die at the end of Persona 3. That game's
yeah,
like 15
nice
years
going,
old.
John. Nice going.
I'm literally John Tron.
You're officially that guy, okay?
That guy. You mean the guy that spoils 15 years old games and doesn't give a shit?
Exactly. Exactly.
Wow. It's almost like I am supposed to give a shit.
It's almost as if you are, yeah. Because I mean, not a lot of people have played Persona 3. Like, I don't fucking know.
Like, if a lot of people have never played it. But that's still no excuse. The game's 15 fucking years old, dude.
I don't know. Like, I mean, keep in mind that Persona 3 is still the best Persona game ever. No matter what people say. So, even... What the fuck are you even doing?
I don't know.
Seriously, what the fuck was that?
I have no clue.
Did you get a little seizure there?
No, I can just extend my tongue. My tongue's not dead. Good.
Some dog is going crazy, by the way.
Oh, wow. So now I have ammo, and now I can shoot shit. The animation quality is really fucking high level.
Wow, that's almost Mighty Number 9 quality.
No, Mighty Number 9 uses PNGs, this is definitely better than that.
Capital shooting, just a few more of the blighters to blast, what the fuck.
Wait, wasn't there zoom mode? I hope there was, because otherwise this is going to get very obnoxious, very fast. Dude, this is really getting really obnoxious really fast.
But you have to shoot all the blighters.
What the fuck are blighters even?
I don't know.
Sounds kinky. Oops.
Everything sounds kinky to you, you're German.
I cannot confirm or deny that statement. Well, I mean, I am German.
I thought you couldn't confirm or deny that statement.
I mean, I'm German, but I'm not kinky. Wait, actually, I'm fucking kinky, Jesus.
You're kinky as shit!
Yeah, I'm definitely kinky as shit, but I don't eat shit, so that's a different story. Don't confuse me for one of those Germans, you know, the degenerate Germans. Dude, like, there's a fun fact about shit-eating porn, right? Most people don't do porn after 3 years anymore. I bet I know why. Because it wasn't very healthy. Like, I don't think it's very healthy. All things considered. Let's not talk about shit eating. So, let's talk about Persona. So, Persona 5. Best Persona so far, yes or no?
Tough question. The thing is, all three of the, like, the modern Persona game, if we can call them that, like 3, 4, and 5, they're all pretty fucking good games, and they're all very different games, so I don't fucking know.
Well, are they really that different, though?
I would say that they're pretty different, yeah. I mean, like, not maybe not mechanically, but tonally, definitely. Because, you know, like, Persona 3, its theme is literally fucking death. Like, it's a game about fucking death. While Persona 4, its theme is fun times with friends and juniors! Yay!
This ham is called Loots a Lot. Well, whatever.
How many pigs are there in the game?
4.
Oh. That makes sense.
Island with a high score. Really, that's your fucking tip? That's a nice tip. I don't know what an island with a high score is supposed to be. Oh, what the fuck is this shit? Ooh, what the hell? Is this a Jinja? Ghostwriters. Oh, I see.
Oh god, those puns.
Ghostwriters. They literally called them ghostwriters. They're just ghosts and they are authors. They're ghostwriters. Go, you get it. It's funny. Love.
It's time to stop.
It's definitely time to just stop it just a little bit.
Wait, why are they cooking him? He's literally a skeleton. What are they gonna cook?
Dude, it's a herd ass pink on it.
But whatever. It's maybe it's a fucking gender fluid skeleton. I don't fucking know.
If there's gender fluids,
did you just assume it's gender?
Yeah.
Wow, check your fucking
white pubic. She's looking a bit malnourished. Yooka just assumed her gender as well. And a bit more fleshed out than you. Okay. This game is weird. I mean, it's very odd to use nose humor.
Let me guess, you can actually take like the entire game without rescuing her and she will still be fine.
Yeah, probably. It's a mascot platform, what do you expect? But those are very ugly pieces of shit.
Kill him with fire.
I was about to pick up the fire. That's a fire, that's a fire. I'm going to kill you with fire so hard you will die to death. People die when they are killed. Looks like dinner's cancelled. Stop with the bad jokes, please. Just stop. For the love of yourself.
It's like a fucking Schwarzenegger character.
So
looks
you are
like dinner's cancelled!
Looks like you are iced! The party is on ice!
Stay cool!
Get to the chopper! Can you feel it in your bones? Please.
Can you feel it in your bones?
Okay, she doesn't actually want to be friends. Who gives a shit then? Get cooked. Whoa, what the fuck? That's dangerous. I was about to roll off there. Oh, ah, Jesus. Maybe you're supposed to roll off here. Let's do it. Nope. You're definitely not supposed to do this. Oh, nice. I warped back to wherever the fuck.
Where that's... even is the same way? It looks like such a confusing game world.
Well, I mean... this level actually is pretty decent, all things considered. I mean, you'll be laughing right now, but this is a fairly Banjo-Kazooie level. They just throw you in there, they give you a few NPCs to talk about, figure it out. It's actually pretty nice, I like it. What the fuck is this? Is this reversed SpongeBob?
It looks like somebody who's played too much Splatoon's wet dream.
Is it a kid now or a squid now? Dr. Puss.
Oh god. Really? More like Dr. Puss, am I right?
Yeah.
Am I right?
You're not wrong.
I
want to clickbait with Persona, but we barely talked about Persona. Let's talk about some Persona.
Okay, fine. Fuck, let's talk about Persona
3. So, let's talk about Persona 3. Ah, you didn't expect this, Adrian.
Hey, I don't mind talking about Persona 3. I fucking love Persona 3.
What's your favorite character of Persona 3?
Oh, man. Fuck. Shinjiro?
Okay, is that the right you are very valid with that. Yes, alright, we can do this.
Like, he is literally the best character.
He's also the very short-lived character, if you know what I mean.
You're not wrong, but, you know, he's still the best character. Maybe that's why he's the best character. He doesn't necessarily die though. If you play a female character,
you play female character, you can save her, but most of the time he just ends up fucked.
Yep. Still worth it though.
Sad because he's pretty fucking good at combat.
Yeah. I mean, why the fuck do you think he dies so quickly?
Because probably it's probably the Auron syndrome. If he would have Auron in the start of Final Fantasy X for too long, it would be just not cool.
Yeah, exactly. Like, if you kept him in the party, he'd kill every shadow with, like, one hit.
Pretty much, yeah.
That overpowered. But yeah, like, actually, this is basically the best reason for playing female character, because you can save Shinjiro.
Yeah, well, I guess. I mean, I think the best reason to play female character is still because at the end of the first boss, you can cry. And she'll buy tries to comfort you on his way.
Oh, yeah. There was, you know, fun fact, originally there was a planned Junpei romance.
Well, no, that doesn't work. There's something
there are audio files in the game, in Persona 3 Portable, for a Junpei romance route.
Audio files?
Oh, yeah.
They went that far, huh?
Exactly.
No, Junpei has a girlfriend, and that's a very sweet romance, so I'm just going to let that stay.
Yeah, I have no idea how they were going to make it work, so... But yeah,
I wanna ascend again. Let's ascend because how do I ascend?
You do not ascend. You only descend. This is a metaphor for your life.
Jesus.
you cannot talk about Persona without getting super dark.
Literally, you can't. I mean, there's literally a check that's like, hey, if you kill me, you can just, you know, the world will be better. You kill me, and then you kill him, and the world's going to end.
I mean, if you don't kill him, the world is going to is also going to end. So it's basically
except if you sacrifice yourself. So if you would be like, if the protagonist of Persona wouldn't be such a fucking wuss and would actually do like what he wants to do for just 1 second, the world would be fucked.
Oh well, you know, he doesn't feel like it. Whatever.
Just... he's an emo. He's just a fucking emo. Look at his face, dude. Like he is all the scenes getting weirdest dream.
Yeah, that's another reason to play as the female character, because male character is a fucking emo.
No, that's actually sad. That's actually sad. Stop. Okay, good. Because that's
hey,
actually
man,
sad.
Don't make me feel...
No, I don't actually stream this right now. Make me feel the fears. Nah, I'm just recording. If I would be streaming this, I wouldn't be streaming it to you on Skype. I would just give you the link to Twitch and be like, oh, here's the game. Comment on it.
Oh, that makes sense. Okay, well, it's your YouTube show, whatever. You're in charge here. If you tell me to shut up, I'm gonna shut up. Whatever.
No, I mean, you're like, dude, don't get it. It's just sad. Stop.
I mean, it's pers- Persona! What are you expecting? Happy fun times? If you want
Persona 4!
Yeah, exactly!
Persona 4 is happy-go-lucky fun times. It actually is pretty fun. Dude, Persona 4 is a very uplifting game, all things considered, even if it's about literal fucking murder, alright?
Yeah,
it's a very uplifting
game. Unless you get the bad ending, in which your little sister dies, you never get the murderer, and everything goes to fucking shit.
But that's the bad, like, if you get the bad ending, then you didn't learn a shit while you were playing Persona. Like, you didn't learn the message, you did get it.
I mean, yeah, basically, there's that, but still... Oh my god, I'm still hoping that you know, one of the worst things about Persona 4 Golden, you know, with all of the shit that it added, was that they didn't add, they didn't give Nanako a Persona. Am I right?
No, that's actually good, because why would the fuck would you add that? Like, that doesn't make sense.
Why does it make sense? Why
Nanako's a group Persona? Member, because Nanako's way too young for this shit.
Why?
Dude,
Ken wasn't that much older than her. He was.
Yeah, but Ken is a very different person than fucking Nanako. Nanako just wants a functioning family. Jesus. She doesn't want to, like, she would literally become the shadow instantly.
Wait, why?
Because all she wants is a functioning family. Which she doesn't have. She doesn't have a mother and her father's never there. That's all she wants. Like, that doesn't make sense. The moment she would get the chance, she would instantly go shadow. Like, holy crap.
But she was given the chance and she didn't even have a shadow.
Well, yeah, because she's pure. So she can't have a persona either.
Oh yeah, but that was super dumb. Why not? Like,
because she doesn't have a shadow. Personas is like the opposite of shadow. Can't have both.
But look. My point is, in Persona
your
4
point
Golden,
is you don't have a point.
My point is that in Persona 4 Golden, they should have changed it and given her a shadow, so that she could have a persona, so that you could add her to the party, so that because every single fucking Persona game needs the obligatory little kid character, like whether it's Ken or is it Nanako or whatever.
Persona 5 doesn't have a little kid character.
Maybe it has, I haven't reached them yet. I mean, I don't know.
No, it legit doesn't have that. It's like,
how do you know?
It's because the game's but 22 years old, not fitting into society.
Well, maybe there is some little kid that isn't fitting into society.
Well, let me guess, the 12-year-old crack whore son from a crack mother that still takes LSD and drugs for 12. Alright, cool.
Okay, why not?
Because that is a little bit too dark for the Japanese society. Have you never read Emergence?
Nope.
You should read Emergence if you want to cry. Like a little fucking baby.
What is even Emergence?
Emergence is a hentai. However, it's a hentai with a story that will literally kill you.
What's it about?
Girl becoming corrupt because she was bullied and became a drug addict and got a child and then kills herself by taking too much drugs.
Oh, of course, yeah. Of course you would read hentai like that.
Yeah, obviously. I definitely need, you know, soul-crushing hentai when I actually get off it.
That's what you get off to, isn't it? Oh my god. Wait, why didn't you pick up that page?
Because it's not a full page. It's just broken.
Okay, then. Wait, what?
It's broken. It's literally broken. Half the page is gone. It's missing.
Oh, so it's torn.
There it is. There's a page part of it. It's three.
I'm the secret Peachy Piece! Two more to go!
Yay, no.
Hire me as a voice actor, please.
No.
My contact information will be in the description.
Yeah, it's www.shithead.com. Oh, there's the last one. That was almost unfindable. I just stumbled upon it on absolute fucking luck, to be honest. Yeah, I would love to assemble you if you would speak to me.
You found all my pages!
Look, now it's a full page. Cool.
You have put me in your butt! Alongside the other pages! It's so dark and moist in here!
Wait, why is it moist inside a book? Why is it moist inside a book?
A butt, Norex, a butt! I said you put me in your butt!
Didn't know that butts are moist. Isn't that kind of, you know, like a little bit dangerous?
Well, I mean, I was kind of making an implication there, but whatever.
I'm not going to put anything in your butts. Fuck off. Oh, look, it's another ghostwriter.
That looks like a character from a game. Hang on.
It looks like a character from a game. Yeah, a ghost sweater from Yooka Laylee.
No, look, hang on.
Hello? Are you still there?
Yeah, I'm here. I'm just looking something up.
I see. Well, I just wanted to end the episode because we've been at it for exactly 1 hour now. And I was like, oh yeah, let's do 1 hour parts.
Oh, all right then. So, any concluding thoughts and shit?
Yes. No.
Oh, no. Boy.
Like, what am I supposed to say?
Do you want me to say the word rape a couple more times? Just no. To make sure that we don't get any... Okay, then.
Please don't.
Okay.
Rape!
You know what makes every joke funnier?
Rape.
No.
Oh.
What makes every joke funnier?
What?
If you just end whatever medium you're consuming during the joke. Kind of like this.